doing things here forever,
eh? Quality stuff.
So,
the whole story of Brave Icon basically started when a guy like myself, after selling denim jeans secondhand, so we call it thrift shopping now, then we used to call it secondhand clothing. I started selling those jeans to the kind of men that knew European brands like your Diesel, your employees, I would like to mention some. But we also then realized, me and a couple of guys that started in this industry, that we could start our own thing. That was the challenge I had to deal with first. So I thought, okay, we're going to buy material where everyone else buys material. Mm. We're going to be buying buttons where everyone else buys buttons. What makes us distinct? What makes us icons?
Yeah.
And then I started experimenting a lot. Thank you to my background in physics and chemistry at high school.
Yeah.
I still remember the basics of mixing, playing around with paints and
art. Oh, yes.
I learned a bit of art also, fine arts. So that came into play. So you can imagine the selling of clothes, the design part comes in, the art comes in, and the mixing of chemicals here and there gave me an edge. So as you see today, our treatments speak for themselves. But there's two reasons for that. One is it's a strategic in the sense that we want to position the brand as a brand that is very sought after, as opposed to a brand that is readily available where people pick and choose whether they want it or not. But we wanted to create sort of a demand. And this demand is purely created by a bit of a scarcity. That's one intention.
Yeah.
Two, we have got a serious problem with denim treatment in SA, which is the washing of the denim. We do also have a problem or challenge with getting good materials. So that coming into play, and then the manufacturing itself is an issue. Equipment and the advancement of equipment compared to where China is now, and Asia and other countries. But Brave Icons is making grounds. We are now available at one of our first stores, which is at Vilagazi Street, the box shop. You can check the product out there. We'll be going very soon online and selling online on other websites that obviously sell. I'm sure there are factors that I could point out that, you know, affect the industry as a whole. One, like, the countries differ in their setting, political setting. You know, you look at China, you're not just competing with China's labor. You're competing with their labor issues, their labor politics in their labor. You know, so there's a whole lot of things that I would say the government needs to look at. But that's like from high, different at a hierarchy. You know, you've got the corporate at their hierarchy saying, we'll fund the designers, we'll put money. Mercedes-Benz is doing so, Audi is doing so. This shows that the corporate is there.
Yeah.
The malls are being built left and right. This is corporate. Yeah.
And those malls, they got like 60% is fashion industry.
Yeah, it's the fashion industry is running it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? After the big anchor tenants.
Yeah.
So this tells you that the business is there, the consumer is there, the designers are there.
Yeah.
What's missing? Unions, I don't want to get too political.
Yeah.
Because it involves now unions.
Yeah.
And, you know what I mean?
I see.
So that is why the scope of what we're talking about could be vast. But generally, if you were to ask me where I would go to after from here, I'd go to an institution that looks at me as a business as opposed to a designer. For example, I go to an institution that will fund a business model that will work. So as opposed to designers looking at themselves always as designers, creative, they need to relook at their business and say, is my business profitable? Am I delving into a product or a category or a industry, I mean a sector that is profitable, you know what I mean? If you're going into there and you know that there are challenges, deal with the challenges first, but don't jump in and then say these are the challenges without having observed them initially. But I can tell you that big things coming for Brave Icon. Brave Icon is working on a few collaborations that are in the pipelines. Collaborations with influential fashion people, collaboration with other brands. But Brave Icon as a brand itself, looking at going overseas via online, looking at supplying stores online. We're also looking at opening our own private store, probably maybe next year, once we have enough of a market.
Yeah.
Money won't be the issue. Can we get a market to walk in a mall and pick up our pair of jeans at the price that we're selling it at now, or even more? You know what I mean? But Brave Icon is basically that brave element of iconism, partnering up, collaborations more than anything.
Okay.
With iconic sports stars, iconic brands, iconic musicians, iconic artists. That is the motto, and that's what drives us. It's collaboration, collaboration, because it's plural.
Yeah.
It's not Brave Icon, it's Brave Icons. Therefore, it takes with it everyone that is iconic and moving forward.